step category. Now the plan for tonight now is we're going to play some Witcher 3. What is that? Dog for mod. Well, Dog, if you want to be mod, what I've got to see is I've got to see regular interaction. I've got to see reliability. I've got to see that you understand my intention for the channel, my intention for the chat, the enforcement of the rules, stuff like that. Just, you know, your kind of interaction style between yourself and other people who are taking part in the chat. That's how Eddie became a mod. I believe I've only got a couple other mods. I've got a couple auto moderators, and I've got one of my very good friends is also a moderator, and it's partly because I'm also a moderator in his channel. But I also know that he would do well as a mod in my channel. So it's just at this point I don't really know you, so it's nothing personal. It's just. Just to let you guys know, you know, anyone else who might be interested in being a mod for my channel at some point, that's what I look for before I make you a mod. So, I don't remember where we were at in The Witcher, but if you guys want to find out, it's up on YouTube. Because I finally got my shit together and updated all the videos on YouTube. So everything is on YouTube except for the TF2 we just played. You always forget modern Edens. Oh wait, is that... That's Alec, right? Yeah, I believe so. Hello, Spartan. Eden. Yeah. Oh boy. What have we got here? We've got a bunch of memers, don't we? Good. My kind of people. Well, this load screen is taking forever. But let's be honest, not nearly as long as the load screens in Fallout 4. Because the ones in Fallout 4 take fucking forever. Alrighty, let's do this one. Priscilla! Holy crap, that's a long distance away. Remember, you're an admin in his Discord chat? That is true. That is true, but like I said, I don't know you personally. Like, I don't really know you. Eddie, how long do you think you had to wait until I modded you on my channel? It was... Oh, that would have made things significantly easier. It was a decent amount of time, wasn't it? How much did this game cost? How much did Witcher cost? I believe I bought this one... Did I buy this one when it was on sale, or did I buy it full cost? I think that The Witcher costs about $60, and honestly, if I didn't pay $60 for it, I would have paid $60 for it, because this game is absolutely phenomenal. Even me, the 130 people. That's fine, you know, it's just... Like I said, this is, I believe, the first or second time you've joined me in chat. You know, so I will continue to monitor, and I do that. I notice people who are regulars, and I notice when they come back. I kind of check and see how they interact with people. So, don't worry. Stalk him. Stalk me for months. Basically, yeah. You know, but yeah, this game is visually very appealing every time. The NPCs are not terrifically friendly. But honestly, it's part of what makes the game kind of fun. The quests are terrific. The storyline has been very good so far. You're able to play this very much at your own pace. There's a little bit of, like, it's a bit of a harsh learning curve of, like, it's like, hey, here's the training thing, and something's following me. You know, it's a bit of, like, here's the training thing, and then, yeah, here you go, out into the world where you can fight pretty much anything at any time. But again, that's part of what makes it kind of interesting. There are areas where once in a while you run into a massive thing that's just miles above your level. But part of what makes this game fun. You never know what you're going to encounter. And the landscape is incredible, enjoyable, you know. It's varied enough. There's always something somewhere. See? You can see there's some enemies up here. It's just a fun game. Oh wait, these are the fuck. Get back! Yeah, I was about to say, these are the guys who, get back, who blow up. Like that. And they actually cause damage. If you're too near them, when they pop. They cause damage. I don't know, it's a fun game. Because it's a game that you can sit down and you can have a fairly intense time with it by going out and, you know, fighting massive mobs and whatnot. Or you can have a fairly chill time by just going out and exploring and a monster's nest with no monsters.
Rock King's nest needs to be destroyed.
I don't trust it. Oh, that's why. There it is. Yes. Now the nice thing is that unlike Dark Souls, they have about a 10-mile lead up to their attacks. Ah, you dick. They've got about 10 minutes where they're just winding up, and it's like, gee, I wonder if they're about to attack me. And yeah, they do. It's just, it's overall, it's a very well-rounded game. It's a lot of fun. They released a bunch of DLC for free. Take notes, EA and Bethesda. And pretty much every other major developer, Rockstar, probably. Well, no, Rockstar releases DLC for free. So there you go. You know? But it's fun. Excuse me. Excuse me. Okay. I'm just gonna leave them alone. Did the chat crash? Oop. Almost knocked my remote off. I've got my stereo remote sitting over here on my laptop, which is where I've got the, where I've got my, the stream chat up. What's over here? What monster is guarding this? Ah! How about you fuck right off? Ow! Bitch. Nope. None of your shit, please. And thank you. Ow! Okay, I got cocky. That one's on me. Nope, back off! Haha! You cannot touch me! See, the thing I've learned is you need to be a little patient with these enemies. You need to be able to just pop in, hit them a couple of times really hard. Ow. And you can't get too greedy. Ah, she got me. Ah, fuck. She pop off too. Maybe she'll try and use. Oh, you dick! Yeah! Finish her! Oh man, she was 2 levels higher than me? Really? Just no one is talking. Yeah, that happens. You know, a lot of times in even larger streams, you get quite a lot of people who just sit there and lurk. You know, it's just the difference is in larger streams that there's enough people that are talking that it's not noticeable always. You know, you get the people who stream and they have like a few thousand viewers all the time. You know, they can stream pretty much anything and they're gonna have a few thousand viewers. There's one guy I follow. And he streamed himself doing homework. He had it in the stream title, just me doing homework. And it's like, that was what he was doing. And he got like, I think 250 followers. Holy shit, there's a lot of enemies out here. Oh, for fuck's sake. What the dicks? You know, it's like, there are people that can do that. They'll get viewers no matter what. You know? And in those. Ah! Ah, fuck you! Fuck you! What's with all the wolves?! You dick! You dick! My gosh! But yeah, in some of those streams, I mean, Doesn't matter what they stream. There's always going to be people talking. There's always going to be people there. Stuff like that. Hell, there's one streamer I know of that he actually has people in his chat when he's not streaming. There's people that are in his chat just talking to each other when he's not even there. It's not even a matter of like, oh, 5 minutes before you scheduled the stream or anything. He doesn't have a schedule. He just... people are just there. I'm like... holy shit! My gosh. It's pretty incredible. Let me actually grab my magic horse. Come here, horse! Yeah. When you get there. Oh, I took a lot of damage in the last battle. More enemies, or are those... no, oh, those are enemies. Oh, what the fuck button did I hit? Hey, oh, it hit some button. Oh, it hit something stupid. Okay. Oh, oh, fuck dicks. Oh my gosh. What the fuck? Oh, these are like toddlers. It's like fucking killing toddlers. Except more legal. Oh my gosh, what the shit? Oh, there's so many of them. They're fucking everywhere, man. Oh my gosh. Like, it's like trying to slaughter an orphanage here. Fuck off! Oh, I need to fucking back up. Oh, no, no, back up, back up, fuck! Are you shitting me? These toddlers are gonna kill me. Eat a dick. By the way, if you haven't actually fought toddlers, or, you know, like, second graders or something, they're fucking annoying. It's actually more difficult than you'd think. Like, they swarm on you, and they just hang on you. And it's actually incredibly difficult. Because, I mean, they're second graders, so you can't really, like, punch them in the face or anything, you know, it's like... yeah, no. Or so I've heard. Yeah, I need to meditate so I can get my enhanced swallow replenished, get my health replenished. I tell you what. Boy, I tell you what! Oh shit, there's a noon wraith? Not even a noon wraith, it's just a fucking wraith! We're just gonna... do one of those. I could've just gone backwards that whole time. Are you serious? Damn it. Alrighty, let's go fuck her up! What could possibly go wrong? Gotta get her into the circle, lure her in. Oh, for fuck's sake, come on, mate. For crying out loud, get into the circle, you bitch! Back off, back off. Yep, gotta get a good couple of strong hits on her. Let her come into the circle. Let her come in. What? How is she not... how did that not damage her? Okay. Here we go. Throw it on the circle. Hit her hard. Hit her fast. Back off. And then... hit her hard. Hit her fast. Woo! Guaranteed! Pretty much, you know, guarantee from the guy who's not that excellent at video games. But still, a guarantee nonetheless. Where did my horse go? Damn it, horse. Oh, they ran off. That's okay, I'm close enough. I'll just run. Right, Horson Jr., I believe I just killed him. So, rip him. Nah, I'll call him the horse. Horse, come here. Come on. Are you quite done, horse? Thank you. Jeez.
Go,
this horse
go.
Is ridiculous. Oh my goodness. It got so cold so rapidly, you guys. It really did. And of course, that was the time that my coat decided that, hey, this would be a great time for my zipper to break. So the thing about my coat is it used to go from this, right, so the bottom of my coat goes basically to my knees, and the top comes up to my beard, actually. The zipper comes all the way up to my beard, which is great. But without the zipper, it only comes up to about the bottom of my neck, or the top of my chest. Which means that when the wind comes through, it blows all that cold air up, and it freezes. What, are there enemies? Were there enemies back there?
Go!
Are you serious? Where were the enemies at?
Move on. Slow now.
Don't see any enemies. Interesting. But yeah, so anyway. So without the zipper. Are there supposed to be enemies? Because that's. It's. Well, I'm very confused. Freak. Oh, fuck off.
Come on.
Oh, okay, I was gonna say apparently horse doesn't want to go in here, but apparently horse can go in here. Oh, okay, I gotta go up. Upstairs. But yeah, so it's rather unfortunate timing for me. Thanks, Coat. The thing is, I've gotta try and figure out if I can contact the company to see if they'll replace it for free by chance, because that'd be excellent. But right now, my monetary resources are, well, zero. Yeah. So, unfortunately, I don't actually have the capability to get it fixed. And I don't know how to fix a zipper, and even if I did, I don't have the tools required to fix a zipper. Wait a minute. Priscilla. This is the girl that, King Radovid is looking for, isn't it? Did I go too far up? Oh, yeah! Goes further back! If she's in here, huh? There she is. Oh, wait a minute! She's the poet, or the lady who was singing a few streams ago.
Yeah.
Tell me, you and Dandelion, how'd you meet?
At a poetry tourney in Ellendale. Naturally, I'd already heard much about Master Dandelion. And it proved true. At first, I thought him a bloated, narcissistic buffoon.
Just at first.
Well, only cows don't change their minds. I changed mine when he came to congratulate me. Never expected he could lose so graciously.
Yeah, she was totally the singer.
Dandelion can be irritating, I shan't deny it. Yet, I also know he can be fair and noble at times. Well, I very much doubt I could bear to have him around were it not so.
Looks like the stream is buffering an awful lot. How bad is it? Yeah, this is looking pretty far behind on my laptop.
Listen, I tracked down Horson Jr.
Yes? And? Did you learn something?
Yeah.
Well, he's dead.
And Dandelion set out to steal Siggy Reuven's treasure for Horson. He promised to find someone who'd fix Ciri's phylactery in exchange.
I cannot believe she parleyed with the bastard. Why? It's widely known how anybody who packs with Wily ends.
Ciri was desperate.
I don't know.
But you're right.
Tell me.
It wasn't the best idea.
Badly?
Horson probably, ended up wounding Ciri just after he tortured Dudu.
Dudu? How is Dudu related to this?
Who is this Dudu character, by the way? Is that somebody I'm supposed to be aware of, or? Ciri.
Luckily, Dudu managed to escape, probably hiding somewhere now.
Is that somebody I'm supposed to have met or something?
Well, Wily.
Who is he?
He's dead.
Yes! Okay, I guess that's the end of that. So Priscilla, that's the one that King Radovid was after, yeah? None of these people realize that, like, a very wanted criminal is right inside there.
If I was seeking to get you drunk, oh, oh, we would not be in a big mess.
Yeah, do a roll, Assassin's Creed style.
Well, well.
Oh, wait a minute.
Freak.
Oh, all right. Nope. So how am I supposed to find out if Ciri is in Novigrad? Just fucking look around, or I'll bet this is one of those where I'm supposed to. All right, let's do. Let's do this one. So we can go ahead and get this one wrapped up. Even though the thing that I'm confused a bit by this game is the fact that so many things claim to be part of the main quest line. There's so many things. It's insane, honestly, because it's like, oh, this is part of the main quest, and this is part of the main quest, and this is part of the main quest, and I'm like, help, shouldn't they all be even connected somehow? Gonna kill you. Yeah, fucking get at me. My gosh. Good night! That was easy. GG, easy. Pugs. But yeah, I'm like, shouldn't all of the,
yes?
The whatchamacallits be connected?
Yes?
Oh, am I? Oh!
Must be the Dropbox.
Oh, okay.
Gave the signal. Spies should show up in Far Corners before midnight.
So where's Far Corners? Over there, apparently. But yeah, and so that is one thing that I am a little confused about by this game, is the fact that all these supposed storyline quests don't really seem to be connected. And I'm like, so how does that work? You know, if all of these are main plotline quests, or main storyline quests, and some of them I haven't, I don't apparently need to complete them. It's not very clear, honestly. It's really not that terribly clear. Right. Let me go ahead and store some stuff while I'm here. Holy nuts. Do I have a silver sword? Ah, yes, this one. And then this is a steel sword. Excellent. Wait, no, I want this one. I don't want that one. 57, 26, hang on. Silver sword. Silver sword. We'll take that one back. Steel, take that one back. And then... getting quite a lot of good armor pieces and whatnot. Why is it buffering so much?
Right.
Now, some people have said that, funny enough, turning off HTML5 has helped solve some of the different issues that the twishues that Twitch has been having. But that doesn't entirely make sense, because HTML5 should help with stream consistency and help with preventing buffering, stuff like that. It's what YouTube has been using for several years by
now.
Looks
like rain.
Yes, Geralt. When it is currently raining, it looks like rain. That's not the smartest guy, is he? Wait, Cleaver. Oh, is Cleaver a dwarf then? Sorry, halfling, whatever. I don't care. It's a video game.
Now just to hide and wait.
Where should I hide? Ah. Apparently I should hide under this bucket.
Best place to hide. Classic.
Well, I guess there's nothing much to do now other than, wait for 9 fucking hours! Holy shit! That's a long time to wait. My goodness. Wait a minute.
Triss? How'd you know to... Dijkstra, huh?
I was about to say.
None other. I couldn't resist. really want to see this through to the end.
I say, how did perfect she's not a spy
with Triss?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, brother.
Ceilings collapsed, mold on the walls, mouse droppings in the corner, lips almost pucker on their own.
He's coming, hide.
No, I do not plan on having sex with Triss. I know some of you guys wanted it, but.
Menge. Indisposed. Very indisposed.
I don't know who you are, but you're in deep. Shit right up to your nostrils.
You're in deeper, I assure you. But answer our questions and we'll help you get out.
The answer to each question will be the same. Sod off.
You'll talk. Just a matter of time. So save us some. Yourself some, too.
I mean, I could just literally cast Axie on him, right?
Or what?
Oh, cast Axie on him?
I'll have to hurt you. Permanently.
I see you know your way around an interrogation. So do I. You're the bad one.
No, she is. I don't believe she's the good one.
Sweet promises.
That's where you're wrong.
Yeah. Oh, on the testicles.
Oh.
Fuck off.
No, bueno.
But I'm just getting started. You must be thinking this can't possibly hurt any worse.
Enough.
Oh no!
Yes! Yes! Just tell me what the fuck about!
Let's draw it out! Why not?
Treasure.
I'm the clue.
You realize one word and you'll howl the pain again.
Yeah. And yet I still say I don't know a thing. So I make you think.
Think he's telling the truth?
I believe he is.
Oh my gosh.
This guy's got electricity in his dick right now.
Sure about that?
Oh.
Radovid.
Oh.
I work for Radovid.
Hang on, let me do this. No, that looks... Is it quiet for you guys?
Radovid, what did he hope to gain by helping Menge?
It seems really quiet for me. Before he arrives.
Makes sense. Easier to take a city whose mages are gone.
Bastard. He'll pay for this.
We're looking for Dandelion. We know Menge captured him.
That's what this is all about. A fucking minstrel. The amount of sense up at the start. Before you bloody started mucking my mind with magic. I can't believe it. For a miserable sap like that.
You expect an apology?
No. But I'm right to be surprised, haven't I?
Fair.
Dandelion is on Temple Isle. In the dungeon beneath the shrine. Menger's planning to execute him in Oxenfurt. Positively spectacular.
Afraid you'll have to call off the show.
How can we free Dandelion?
Those who leave Temple Isle.
Is she able to just hold this spell forever?
Issued in person.
Damn it.
We'll find a way. I have an idea. Tell you
Kill
later.
Kill everyone on the island.
Enough. We've learned everything we wanted to.
Glad to hear it. Can I assume?
So this dude still has electricity in his penis, or what?
Not so fast. Geralt.
I know. He's seen too much.
Why? I told you. I'll never.
Either he dies, or I wipe his mind.
Take his memory.
Strip him of his memory.
I don't want to have to kill him unnecessarily.
But I helped you. I helped.
It's not so bad. I promise.
Peace. I'm sorry, friend.
Gay and gay.
Sorry, buddy. But at least you get to live. Hopefully,
really showed your claws today.
Is that how you see it? I'd put it differently. I showed how little I differ from these bastards. Let's finish up and leave. I want to go home, bathe, and get drunk.
Hey!
Walk you home?
Not today, Geralt. Not today. But there is one other thing I wanted to talk about. So, mind coming by later? Menga's dead, true, but that hardly marks the end of my troubles.
Said you had an idea about freeing Dandelion.
Yes. We know he's on the island, and he'll stay there until Menga orders him transferred to Oxenfurt, right?
Mm-hmm. Problem is, Menga's dead. So...
No one else knows that. He could have escaped the fire. He could reappear.
So was Menga the one that I saw getting burned at the stake a while ago?
Very similar.
Long while ago, no, jeez.
Your old friend Dudu Biberveld impersonated the halfling merchant. Dandelion claimed he seemed more real than the original. So much so, Vivaldi gave him a loan of several thousand crowns without batting an eye.
Yeah, except Dudu's in hiding right now. Priscilla might know something, though.
Damn it! I should have done this one before talking to Priscilla so I could have wrapped up multiple quests all at once. Fucking hell. Oh, okay, bye. Nope, nobody to kill, yeah? Meet Triss Marigold. Alrighty, yeah. So I could have just gone and wrapped up multiple quests all at once. Doggone it! Bit of a pain in the ass, but meh. It's okay. We get more time in this incredible world. I mean, it's just astounding. Somebody had to fucking make all of this. And I mean, that's the thing that really blows my mind about video games these days, is like, especially like this. Like, this didn't just fucking happen. Right? Like, this didn't just magically appear on its own. Like, somebody had to make this. Somebody had to sit down and make this. Each thing you see, somebody had to make. Now, it's... For one building, normally you hire an architect in real life, right? To design a fucking world? Like, they designed an entire country. I mean, a lot of it is definitely, you know, it's open countryside, just rolling hills and stuff. You know, it's trees, flowers, stuff like that. But then other stuff is like... you know, peasants' huts and whatnot. You know, not super difficult, but some of this, like, you look at some of this, and it's like you've got castle walls, and you've got, you know, like this house in front of us, right in front of us, right there. You know, you've got the towers in the distance. You've got the we've been up and seen the temple of the hidden fire. What is it called? The rolling fire, whatever it's called, right? You know, it's like, so you've got all of that. Then you've also got the characters. You've got the characters we interact with, like Triss and Yennefer and Ciri and Baron and the Crones and all these other people, right? And you've got Geralt, of course, but then you've also got the NPCs and the locations and where they sit and the things that they say and all these other things. And these drunks, the beggar and the drunk there, the people we just walk past, we don't even talk to them, ever. I mean, I could play this entire game, never even remember them, right? Not need to. It's just, it's incredible to me. I mean, somebody had to sit there. Somebody had to make this door, right? Somebody had to make this, I think it's just... It's just outstanding. Honestly, it truly is. It's just terrific. Uncouth. Fuck you. Uncouth. I suppose just popping off with a fuck you is not really proving that I'm not uncouth. Oh well. Hey, Priscilla. How you doing?
Got a plan, but we need Dudu. Gotta find him.
This plan?
Oh, maybe I needed to talk to her beforehand.
Our Doppler friend will assume Menga's form. Order Dandelion move to Oxenfurt. We can grab him on the way.
Brilliant. But how do you aim to find Dudu?
You're his friend.
Well, I could just eat some sausage and then...
With the Doppler, the question's never where, but as whom? In the past, facing trouble, he'd disappear, then reappear on the morrow with someone else. But this time he hasn't returned.
Maybe he's dead!
Known Dudu long.
I know this might sound strange, but I can't be sure. It seems he's been circling me for some time in various forms, trying to attract my attention.
Can't blame him for making the effort.
Hey, is he flirty?
I failed to notice him at first.
Look at Geralt being so smoothly flirty.
What tipped you off? How do you know it wasn't Dandelion? Dudu not much of a singer.
No. He simply spoke about something other than himself.
We need to convince Dudu to reveal himself. Any friends we could leave a message with, someone he trusts?
Dandelion? Irina Renard's troop, that's all really. Not certain he was friendly with anyone else. Spent dawn till dusk with the troop, on stage or in the crowd.
So he liked going to the mummings?
Yes, I'm actually surprised he didn't come to us after it all happened. He certainly could have counted on the Foxen's help.
So if these mummers are ready to help...
Right, somebody had to design this interaction, like...
Deeply indebted to him.
That's amazing! I just... Every time I play this game, Fallout 4, GTA 5, honestly, GTA 5, sure, why not? Yeah, that's another great game. You know, good example, stuff like that, where it's like, this kind of thing, it's just, it's incredible to me. People had to design all of these things. It's not necessarily random happenstance.
Dudu and the mom mistakes me. How they meet.
That was my doing, some opening night. Maxim lay comatose in his wardrobe, drunk as a otter. I thought of Dudu. Hard to imagine a better actor than a Doppler.
And Dudu revealed himself to them just like that?
I didn't think it wise to tell anyone. But Dudu and Irina took to each other completely and right away. He fell so hopelessly in love with the theater.
That he started performing with you?
Yeah. Now Irina feels terribly guilty. They let him put himself in danger. She can't forgive herself.
Maybe we could use a play. You know, work a message to Dudu into something. Lure him out of hiding that way.
Not a bad idea, but I doubt a few lines would suffice.
Yeah, that's the thing I was thinking about a play.
Do you think Dudu whiles away his days attending mummings he knows by heart?
So what do you suggest?
I'm not talking about mummers play, I'm talking about a good one.
From scratch? Something grand. Something that will grab Dudu's attention.
It's gotta spread through the people to ensure that he hears it.
It must be the talk of the town. If you wish, we can start on it right away.
See? I actually knew what I was talking about! Wow! That's phenomenal! That comes from a just fantastic series of books, by the way. The Name of the Wind series of books by Patrick Rothfuss. If you like reading at all, pick those up. Just stellar books. Oh my gosh, just... absolutely phenomenal. My favorite series of books that I've ever read, and I love it. There's two books out right now out of three, and I have read them I don't know how many times. I love them.
Sure,
I recommend them highly to everybody. They're just fucking fantastic, especially if you like Lord of the Rings.
You'll see. We'll have a grand time together.
All right. Guess we can start writing the play.
Any ideas for the plot?
Actually, I was hoping.
The key is to convince Dudu that he can rely on you, and that we wish to free Dandelion. The message must be clear, though naturally woven into the play's dramaturgical essence, meaning we need an appropriate dramatic structure. Following along?
Not entirely.
Tough. You'll need to pick it up as we go along. There's no time to explain everything to you.
Oh.
Now to find the proper expressive form for our content. A gripping, contemporary story, that would be best. Perhaps about the condottieri of Povis. I know. Lorenzo Molla.
Can I sex up Priscilla?
A handsome but ruthless bandit. And the Doppler who manages to fool him. But now the Doppler must hide, and can only count on the help of his friend, who's a Witcher, who in turn is prepared to do anything to save his better, his beloved. What do you think?
It's actually pretty good. But a little direct, isn't it?
Sounds great.
Really think so? Lorenzo Moller. Yeah. Or perhaps not. Wait, I've got it! We shall stage a story of the Urchin of Erlenwald. Secret lovers, their betrothal, a curse, a cruel queen, bells sounding midnight.
But...
At which point he reveals his face. He's a monster, there to steal Princess Palvetta. They want him dead, but at that instant, a Witcher steps in. And everything ends splendidly. So it's settled, yeah? You wish to say something?
Give me a sec, guys. I'm doing a little bit of Googling here to see if, oh my gosh. Okay, so it is just the three main ones. Alrighty, sorry for the delay there. I was just double checking, seeing if there was anything I was gonna miss.
Will I get a say in any of this, or have you decided everything already?
Why are you cross? It's the nature of the creative process. We toss around ideas and choose the best ones.
Meaning yours.
Well, you must admit I'm better acquainted with the theatre.
I mean,
naturally,
she does have a
part
point.
In shaping this play. Contribute to the work as a whole. Dandelion will explain how it works later.
My desk is humming. It's weird. My desk is vibrating. I don't know why.
We need a good title. Venture to say that's more important than the story itself.
Hello?
Hey. I have some ideas. Perhaps you can choose.
Wait, what?
Can I consider my opinion this time?
Of course.
Alex?
We're partners in this.
What are you doing?
I'm just in charge. I've two really good ones.
Oh, I thought you guys had left already for
Bismarck. The
changeling rescue of the witch's triumph.
Gosh, we would have, if we left for Bismarck, we would have been there at like late, very late in the day.
I was very confused.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Let's see. I like the Doppler Salvation.
Let's go with the Doppler Salvation. It's shorter, catchier.
Yep.
Just one problem. No Dopplers in that story.
Oh,
just
whoops.
A princess and a cursed urchin.
Nothing. Maybe paying attention would be beneficial for success in this game.
The message, that's what's important. A witcher arrives and saves the Doppler. Got it?
Alright. So it's a comedy.
Tragedy.
I was thinking more along dramatic lines.
Oh, that.
But if you prefer something lighter... Listen, merely decide and I'll get to
So we're, are we actually going to... Drama. It'll pack more
You're
punch.
Right.
People will be into it.
The drama'd be better.
Very well. I must get to
Comedy
work.
Is easy.
While you...
It's fun. Which is good. But...
Sit down. Read silently or... Just think.
Since you don't need help with the writing.
Do I have any say in this?
Geralt.
Oh yeah, definitely. Just go sit over there and read and be silent.
Did it, sure.
Ugh. Just keep quiet.
And he falls asleep. That's fucking magnificent.
Done. I could make a small masterpiece of this had I a bit more time, but...
Her outfit is...
The hidden message.
Interesting.
What did you leave in?
Hidden message?
You were gonna work something in, like come to the Kingfisher at dawn, or...
That wouldn't be in keeping with the tone of the play, not at all!
You wrote it to contact Doodoo. That was the purpose. Fine. So how do you see this working?
I don't know. I was counting on recognizing him by his scar. Or just improvising? Shall we worry about that later?
So she didn't even First write in the fucking message! That's insane!
Sure you know where to find
Unbelievable. Oh my gosh.
Join us later. See ya.
Holy shit, that's... Hey, I leveled up! I don't know if it does me any good at this point. because I don't know if I have any ability to... This is what she came up with. Witcher, to slay beasts most foul, 'twas for this I was made. I kill as my calling, not just to get paid, said in a threatening manner. Witcher, perhaps midst the guests he hides in fear? Suspicious. Witcher, seems men's hearts can love for changelings foster. Astonished. Okay, so let me... To slay beasts most foul, 'twas for this I was made. I kill as my calling, not just to get paid. I'm trying to now read them in the way that it says I should. And then, perhaps midst the guests he hides in fear. Then, as astonished, seems men's hearts can love for changelings foster. And then disgusted, but a heart that is base, such as in this knave aches. And ceremonial. How the fuck do you say something ceremonially? Maybe we can ask my roommate, who's in an incredible yellow sweater and just got a wonderful haircut.
Look at his
flaxen silky hair.
Why everybody is so freaked out about the fact that
I don't know, the fact that it's exactly, that's the thing, the fact that it's yellow is like
yellow.
Yeah, it's weird to see on you. It looks like something I'd see on,
because I wear a lot of edgy colors.
I don't know.
Does it mean I can't wear edgy colors? So jokes on you, asshole.
I don't know, bud. I don't know. It's so yellow. Megan, is his yellow sweater kind of weird but also wonderful? Yeah, see? Exactly!
All day.
It's fucking amazing! Did they stop you at the airport and went, hold on, sir, we believe you've mugged somebody else because there's no way you'd wear that kind of sweater?
Yeah, actually, this is the first time in the airport that I wasn't.
Well, they probably... Actually, that might be a combination of haircut and sweater.
Yeah, it's definitely a combination.
I actually bet so, especially with your long hair.
Yeah. I got TSA agent even commented. He's like, oh, you got your haircut. I was like, yeah. <You're
right>. Amazing. Amazing. I'm sorry. I love it. Oh, man. So, said ceremonially, no monster is he whose shape can shift.
Oh!
I love it.
If I was seeking to get you drunk, madame, we would go into the
discomfort.
I love it. It's magnificent. Look at how yellow it is!
God damn it!
It's so yellow!
The world will burn! Burn in the eternal fire!
I think I'm yellow.
It's approximately 6, maybe even 7 yellow.
7 yellow,
yeah.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. Hey, by the way, I was rewatching a little bit of our Fear 3 stream. I'm thinking we should, do that again.
What restream?
The Fear 3 stream.
Oh, yeah.
We should do that again. That was
the game again?
Yeah, the co-op again.
Okay.
It was fun.
It was. It was a good game.
Because I was uploading a bunch of shit to YouTube today, and I was kind of scanning through some of the older stuff, and I saw that, and I was like, That was a lot of fun.
Yeah, that game was quite fun.
I was very bad at it, and you cheated, clearly, in order to win at the end. You dirty... What's that? Hold on.
What do you mean, still running? Why would it not be?
You mean functional?
No. It is still filling. Don't you fear the
pirates? Why wouldn't it be?
Wait. Do you mean it was stuck running when you left?
I don't know. I'm saying it is when I came into the room, when I just got back and came into the room.
It sounds like it's filling right now.
I don't know.
Why don't you take a look? Oh, for fuck's sake. The chain must be stuck under. Yeah, it's clearly. Just fiddle the handle. Just fiddle the handle. Memorial Derby. Ride Ronald. You don't have to flush it, don't know.
You guys like the view of my bathroom?
That is
the toilet where I take all of my dumps. Alright, an invitation to the Memorial Derby. Take heed, one and all. Citizens of the free city of Novigrad and foreigners alike, the venerable Vagelbud family has the honor of inviting you to the annual Great Erasmus Vagelbud Memorial Derby.
Yeah, Jones, that fixed it.
We welcome both spectators and contestants wishing to take part in the races. As it is every year, the derby will be held on the grounds of the Vagelbud's residence. Seek out the master of the races with any and all questions.
Alright, well, I don't really give a shit about that right now. I've got other things going on. But you know what? You know what? Why don't we go ahead and actually call it a night?
I'm thinking that's good. Yeah. You guys can witness my glorious bathroom. Behold, the location in which I take all my poops. Alrighty. Oh, golly, that was a long day of streaming. It wasn't an entire day, of course, but that was a few hours there.
Don't worry about shutting the door, because I'm not...
Too late, I already did.
Just open it again. Dick.
Now you gotta...
I'm gonna kick you. Hang on, guys. I have to kick my roommate real quick.
Oh, okay, he opened the door.
Okay.
I opened it only after you stood up.
Oh,
yet another victory.
Such a bastard. Such a bastard. This is why I don't like my roommate, you guys. This is what you can hear him fucking cackling in the background. The madman he is, wearing a yellow sweater of all things. But yeah, it was a fun day. I'm actually going to work on getting these videos uploaded to YouTube right away. I don't believe I have any editing to do. So I should be able to get them up tonight. At this point, like I've been saying, I don't really have any plans for scheduling more streams. It's just that I'm trying to stream more frequently. We can take a look maybe at some point at regularity, but I figure at this point, let's just try and to...
Yeah, shut up, Jones. You look like an old person, okay? So you shouldn't be the one talking about regularity.
My sweater, bomb ass, and fucking jealous.
I don't know about that, but...
No, man, that's what it sounds like to me.
Anyway, as always, thank you for watching. Sorry for your suffering. Take care, and I'll see you next time.